Hello students, I welcome you all to the e-learning sessions of Automobile Engineering. Myself Hardik Shah, and during this lecture series, we will discuss some interesting topics in the subject of automotive electricals and electronics, right? We have already started a new session on the chapter of batteries and starting system, right? And our today's topic in this video is basics of starting systems. Okay, I hope you will see this video till the end to completely understand this topic and gain your skills in automotive engineering. Okay, I request you also to note down the queries arises during the lecture and ask it in comment section. I will try to solve all the queries as soon as possible. Okay, so without wasting much time, let's start our video. So in a day-to-day life, we use our vehicles daily. Okay, so how we start it actually? So we use a key or we turn the key for the electric start. But what is the connection between the key and, or you can say, what is the starting system of the engine? So as we know, the piston and cylinders are the heart of the IC engine, right? And piston is moved by the crank. So this must be rotated for it, and this rotation is given by the key, or you can say electric starter. So when we kick, it actually rotates the flywheel and crank, and then piston will move reciprocation motion. Okay, and as the other systems like battery and ignition are also on, the engine will start. Okay, and once it is started, the fuel will do its work to keep it in running condition. Fine. So we can say that to bring the engine running on a fuel, we must run it first by our own or by a key. Okay, and if we want to give it an electric start, then electrical starting system is required, and thus we can say that the starting system is the heart of all the electrical systems in a car. Okay, so what actually happens in electric start? So as we know, it all begins with the battery because it is the main source of electric power. The key is inserted into the ignition switch and then turned to the start position. Okay, a small amount of current then passes through the system, which is made up of the neutral safety switch to the starter relay or starter solenoid, which allow the high current to flow through the battery cables to the starter motor. Okay, so the starter motor then cranks the engine so that the piston moving downwards can create a suction. Okay, and that will draw the fuel air mixture into the cylinder, where a spark is created by the ignition system, which will ignite the mixture. Okay, now if the compression in an engine is high enough and all this happens at the perfect timing, the engine will start. Okay, so we can say that it converts the electrical energy to the mechanical energy to operate the engine, and this is the principle of starting system. Now let's see the main requirement of the starting system. So we can say that an internal combustion engine requires a combustible mixture first, thereafter compression stroke, that means second, and thereafter a form of ignition, and last one, the minimum initial starting speed, you can say approximate 100 rpm, okay, in order to start and continue running. Okay, so to meet the first three of this requirement, the minimum starting speed must be attained. Okay, means we need to rotate the crank at minimum starting speed. This is where the electrical starters come in a picture. So attainment of this minimum speed is again dependent on the number of different factors. So which are these factors? First, the rated voltage of the starting system. Okay, thereafter, the lowest possible temperature at which the engine can still be started. Now this is known as the starting limit temperature. Okay, next, the torque required to crank the engine at its starting limit temperature, means it is including the initial stalled torque, it is also required. Okay, next, the battery characteristics that we must know. Thereafter, the voltage drop between the battery and the starter motor. Okay, thereafter, the starter to ring gear ratio, it is also required. Okay, thereafter, the characteristics of the starter motor, means what type of motor it is. Okay, thereafter, the minimum cranking speed of the engine at the starting limit temperature, it is also required. Fine. So these are all the requirements of the starting system. Next is talk terms which are actually very useful for understanding the starting systems. Okay, so let's discuss all these terms one by one. First is engine breakaway torque. What is this? So it is the torque required to start moving the engine crankshaft from the rest position. It is its definition. Okay, next, engine resisting torque. What is that? So once the engine has started moving, the torque required to keep it moving, okay, it is termed as a resisting torque. Okay, and it is about one half of that breakaway torque. Okay, next is motor locked torque. So what is that? So it is the torque developed immediately the battery current is switched on, okay, so that the armature starts rotating from the rest position. It is more than the engine breakaway torque. Okay, why? Because it has to commence the rotating to the crankshaft. Done. And last one is the motor driving torque. And what is that? So it is the torque of the motor when the armature shaft pinion gear is driving the flywheel gearing. Okay, so it is a greater than engine resisting torque. Fine. So these are all the torques which is required in understanding the starting system. Okay, so let's now discuss in very brief that how this starting system works. So in any automobile, the starting system first cranks the engine initially. Okay, it has replaced manual effort to the crank the engine with the help of the cranking rod that was used in ancient days, that actually it is kick. Okay, so initially the engine requires cranking, but once the cycle is completed, it starts and runs on its own by the fuel. Okay, in two wheeler it is common to the kick start the engine, but in recent times the number of manufacturers have introduced button start, or you can say start electric start. Okay, for initial cranking the electric motor is provided that gets electric current as an input from the battery. The mechanical energy in the form of rotation of the shaft is transmitted to this engine, and this provides the initial movement of the crank, which is connecting to the crank, thereafter connecting rod and the piston. Okay, so as soon as the spark occurs, the fuel will ignite it. Okay, and the output becomes available for the engine. Done. So no more cranking is needed and the starting system stops working and the engine run on its own with the help of fuel. Okay, so the starting system makes a starting of vehicle very convenient just by a push button. Done. So now let's discuss which are the different circuits in a starting system. So a starting system consists of two circuits, that is starting the motor, then magnetic switch, safety switch, battery cables and ignition switch. So these are the main components. Okay, these all are components connected with each other through two circuits. One is starting circuit, second is control circuit. Okay, the starting circuit in which the high current flows, which is used to start the engine. Okay, and the control circuit in which the low current flows. The ignition switch acts as a switch for the starting circuit also. Okay, so in starting circuit you can say the current flows from the battery to starter motor through the solenoid, or you can say magnetic switch. And the control circuit connects magnetic switch with the battery through the ignition switch. So that was the controlling circuit. Okay, so this was the main devices that is actually using in a starting system. So we will discuss all these major components in a starting system in next videos. Okay, so which are the some important questions that can be answered from this video. So first question will be, explain the principle of starting system. Thereafter, explain the circuits inside the starting system, two circuit, starting and control. Thereafter, explain the requirement of the starting systems. So there are many requirements of starting systems. Thereafter, explain the torque terms. Okay, so you need to explain the each torque one by one. Okay, so that's it in today's session. I hope you learn a new thing today. Once again, I request you to write down your queries in comment section to solve your doubts. Okay, in next section we will discuss about the major components of starting system, and thereafter we will discuss about how the starting system works. So I hope you like this video. Thank you so much. Keep learning. Goodbye.